Honey, allow me to be your sign that you have been asking for and been needing to let go of that situation that has been doing nothing but causing you stress and anxiety, honey. It is not worth it for it to be living in your mind rent-free and you're not being paid for it, honey. Hey, girl. Hello, my beautiful Sagittarius. How are you doing? My name is Simply Velka, and today I'm going to be doing your weekly or daily reading, depending on how you receive this reading, but it's a bonus one nonetheless. I do your general weekly zodiac reading for your sign Sagittarius, which I'll leave a link to above for you to check out at a later point. But when it comes to my readings, of course, you know, Sagittarius, be sure to rely on your intuition. Take the cards that resonate, leave what doesn't. And I'm not going to be offended by it. These readings here are just here to provide some food for thought, perspective to consider, but never making the choice in your life because it is your life to live, Sagittarius, not mine, and not these tarot cards. If you enjoy this tarot reading, Sagittarius, I'd really appreciate it if you were to give this video a like and subscribe, because it does help out my channel a lot. Be sure to give this video a comment as well by letting me know which tarot cards resonate with you. And yeah, Sagittarius, let's just get into your bonus tarot reading today. Ooh, and you guys got an extra card. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see it? Yeah, you can see it, honey. Let's get started. All right, Sagittarius, let's get into your reading. So the beginning cards that we have for you, we have the Five of Swords, of course, the Tower card, the Queen of Pentacles, as well as the Temperance card, Sagittarius. So definitely, something came crashing and burning in front of you, Sagittarius, I get a sense for. And because of that experience, it really got you in your head about something. Now, I know, Sagittarius, for your weekly tarot reading that I did for you this week, you guys were in this process, Sagittarius, of making a transition from certain people in your life, certain projects that you were doing. It was almost like you were reallocating where you're putting your energies, almost, because something came to a closure. For some of you Sagittarius, it's hitting you pretty hard right now. Or maybe this is like kind of like the delayed effects of mentally of what's happened to you after something kind of came crashing and burning down, or some type of, yeah, I would say crashing and burning down, Sagittarius. Definitely, I feel like this could be in terms of just like projects or really anything, right? Something just didn't work out, right? With that Tower card and with the Five of Swords, I hold them up together because it is like such a pairing, I feel, Sagittarius, because with this Five of Swords, this is the card, if you look at the card closely, this is, you see, I kind of see this as the representation as like your inner, like kind of like the devil on your shoulder whispering doubtful thoughts in your head, or you hearing like people in the background shouting things that just overall are not making you feel good. And just, it's almost just like now you can't stop thinking about how this Tower moment happened and how like it just has impeded you in such a way. And so then we have the Temperance card and the Queen of Pentacles coming in for you as well, Sagittarius. Now, this is where, I know it sounds like just such a cop-out, Sagittarius, but it is kind of like waited out, Sagittarius. Your story is going to be getting so much better because you have this Temperance card coming in. This is that divine timing. Things are going to work out in the way that they're meant to be working out and for you, Sagittarius. So this lets me know, dare I say, I would even say the spirit kind of had this Tower moment happen for some of you Sagittarius, is because you really didn't want to let go of this. And it's kind of, I do feel like it's essential for you to let go of something that came crashing down, because spirit has bigger plans for you, has a much brighter future than what you're anticipating, Sagittarius, because of this Queen of Pentacles here. Queen of Pentacles is the card of being able to take care of yourself, that extremely just someone that's like content with being by themselves, and just overall just such an energy of being a boss, right? Being self-employed, being a boss, not really needing anybody, and really kind of having the Midas touch with something, Sagittarius. So even though you got in your head because of this Tower moment come crashing down, that King crashing down in front of you, Sagittarius, do not take this as a sign of something that you are personally lacking in, because I don't feel like you're lacking in anything. This Tower moment was essential. This is something you couldn't have avoided, right? so just get out of your head about the Sagittarius, you know. If something was meant to, if something was trying to leave your life or is leaving your life, or something is just crumbling down, it's truly meant to happen at this point. Like, it's, I know it sounds like such a cop-out, but it truly is. Like, especially when you have the Temperance card, this is just such a powerful message paired with this Sagittarius. So now we get into your clarifying cards. As my cat over on the side starts playing in her little litter box for some reason, honey, so don't mind that. But we have for your extra cards your High Priestess, the High Priestess rather, the Knight of Swords, Sagittarius, the Knight of Pentacles, the Ten of Pentacles, as well as the Page of Cups, Sagittarius. So this is how your story gets better, essentially, with these beautiful cards, right? So with this energy, there's something that, I get this feeling, Sagittarius, when the opportunity presents itself, you're gonna really know. And it's coming to you really quickly. It's in the works quickly. I don't know how fast it'll come to you, but when you have these two knights, right, actually, funnily enough, you have the fastest moving knight as well as the slowest moving knight paired with this Sagittarius. But it's all in the name of the Page of Cups. But I'm getting ahead of myself. What do these cards even mean for you, Sagittarius? The Knight of Swords is the new ideas. The Knight of Swords is the really creative individual who's just... To me, I'm taking this as a sign that some type of creative project that's coming to you that's going to bring forth a lot of abundance, right? That's going to bring forth more stability, like bring forth stability in general in your life, because I don't feel like you're feeling really stable in general with this tower experience, Sagittarius. But what does this look like with the Page of Cups, right? This is where it's like the defining message of what's coming to you, right? With this Page of Cups here, this could be coming in as a sign of, even the definition, Sagittarius is a sign of a new person entering your life. But the Cups could also represent a new opportunity presenting itself to you that is a creative pursuit that would bring forth a lot of stability, right? And it's funny that you have the Queen of Pentacles as that energy, like pentacles. Like, actually, you didn't get any wands cards, which isn't a bad thing at all, Sagittarius. It just really spirits like emphasizing the message of like pentacles, of stability, of financial abundance, right? All your cards are like really focused in on that and how that's coming forward to you. So Ten of Pentacles, this is what's going to be happening, right? This is going to grow to be, Sagittarius, is this Ten of Pentacles. You look at the card, it's that family life. It's having your cake and eating it too. Complete stability, complete, you know, you're taken care of, right? Your finances are there. And then with the High Priestess card, this is just such a dynamic of where truly, Sagittarius, is, I would say, you're going to just definitely know what's in the works for you really soon. I feel like this is for some of you guys. Anytime I see the High Priestess card, I always kind of associate this as where it's just like, okay, intuitively you kind of have an idea of what this would be about, or you kind of intuitively know that this is like part of the process for you. And more so, the message comes in as an affirmation to let you know that you are not crazy for whatever it is that you're thinking and feeling in the journey that's ahead, Sagittarius. You really are on the path of having such a beautiful, bountiful, like abundant story. But you know, what is any good story without there being a couple of curveballs being thrown at you, right? Beautiful, beautiful energy, Sagittarius. I'm going to close this reading out for you with an oracle card, and we're going to use the moon. Oh, y'all even get like a little what's up from a cameo from Miss Tulip. So yeah, I'm going to be pulling an oracle card, moon oracle card for you, Sagittarius, to close out this reading. So let's just see what card steps forward for you, Sagittarius. Right, I actually feel drawn to do two. So we have the balsamic moon. It's a time for healing, definitely talking about this. Definitely, I feel like do whatever it is you need to do, Sagittarius, to get yourself out of your head and also just immersing yourself in some nature. I can't help but suggest that to you. Probably a bias just because I like going out in nature, but I do feel like you guys, Sagittarius, need to have like a mental reset from this experience, right? Maybe you guys haven't taken a pause after this huge coming apart on something, right? And I feel like you need to have that breather. And full moon in Leo, don't let your pride get in your way. Don't let pride get in your way. So don't be afraid of asking for help. Don't be afraid of kind of like letting this fall, Sagittarius, for some of you guys, if you're still fighting to keep it up, right? And you're trying to just, with all your might, try to keep it going just from a personal sake, right? Something's meant to be gone in your life. Let it go, Sagittarius. Get out of your head. Let it go. Don't see it as a failure or anything that you're lacking, Sagittarius, because you're not lacking anything at all, I promise you. So, yeah, Sagittarius, that is the reading that I have for you, your bonus weekly or daily reading. If you enjoyed this reading, let me know in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe, Sagittarius. Also, remember to check out your weekly zodiac reading, and I will connect with you guys in the future, in your future, hopefully. I love you so much, Sachi. Bye.